Cool.
Okay, hello everybody. Welcome back to another episode of the Alternative Chef Show on YouTube. Tonight we are in the steamy jungles on the Big Island of Hawaii. And we're going to do Kalua pork, and obviously I'm not going to do an emu and put it in the ground and do all that stuff. I'm actually going to do it right in the oven. Anybody could do this from their own home if they have the right greens to work with. Tonight we're fortunate enough to have banana leaves and tea leaves right here in the yard, so that's not an issue. Let's jump right into it. Okay, I've done all the prep work I need to do for marinating the pork already. What I have is a 1 gallon resealable plastic Ziploc baggie, and I have about 5.5 to 6 pounds of pork butt. And what I've done is I have added about 6 cloves of garlic. I've chopped them up and minced them. I've also added about a full tablespoon and a half to 2 tablespoons of freshly grated ginger. I also have added about a tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce, if I said that right, excuse me if I didn't. I've also added a little bit of liquid smoke, about a teaspoon of liquid smoke, really strong stuff, gives it great flavor, liquid smoke. I've also added about a teaspoon of rock salt. Okay, also I've added about 8 tablespoons of soy sauce right into the bag. And I've got that marinating in there. Let's see, did I miss anything? I think that's it. That's all you need for this. I've also thrown in about 6 or 8 whole cloves of garlic. You don't need to do that, but I like garlic that's been marinated and cooked in the oven. I love that, so I put that in there as well. Okay, so I've got this in my baggie here, and I've been massaging it. This has been in here for about 20 minutes. It needs to sit at room temperature for about 1 to 2 hours at room temperature marinating, okay? So this is good to go, and let's work on our little emu here. This is an oven-style emu. Okay, I've got banana leaves that I've cut up. I actually have to cut up a couple more here. Let's do that right now. Okay. I'm going to cut these banana leaves just to fit this tinfoil. I've got a large sheet of tinfoil that's large enough to fit the pork onto there. So what I'm doing is I'm just cutting these banana leaves just like that, cut off the ends. Okay, and I'm going to set these right in the center of the foil. I'm going to center those in there. You want to make sure there's about 1 inch on each side because we're going to be rolling this up and sealing it up to the top. Okay, so I also have tea leaves. These also grow right here on the property, so they are readily available. Obviously, you're not going to use these back home. You can use collard leaves or spinach leaves or whatever you want, but the ingredients today calls for tea leaves and banana leaves. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to layer these right on top of the foil. So I've got heavy-duty aluminum foil that's going to go right into the oven. I've got 2 large banana leaves that I've set right on top of the foil, and then I've got my tea leaves. All these I've washed thoroughly, and I'm going to set those. These are large tea leaves. I'm going to put those right on there like that. All right. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to put the pork right on top of this. Now, I told you that we need to marinate the pork in the bag for about an hour. Again, this has only been in here for probably about a half hour now, but I'm going to actually roll this up and let it marinate right inside the leaves as they are. So I'm going to use my hands here just like that and place the pork right on top of these leaves just like that. Place the pork, kind of make it so you can roll it fairly easy, alright? Again, this is about 5.5 to 6 pounds of pork butt. And I've got that right in there like that, and I'm going to pour the rest of this. Actually, let's hold on. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to actually start to roll this up. So kind of roll the foil in the banana leaves, just like that. Actually, pull this over just a little. Okay, so I'm going to roll this like this. Bring this up together like with the foil on the edge and just sort of fold it over like that. And then I'm going to fold up the edges. That. we've got our little homemade emu here, and I'm going to open this back up just enough to pour the remaining juices from the bag inside of here. Pour that right in there. Okay, so we're doing good here. I have a special guest coming on next that's actually going to make a piña colada for us. Tommy Stark is my guest today, and he is going to be doing a piña colada right here on the show. So once again, I've got my little homemade emu ready to go. The pork is wrapped in here. Now, I'm not going to cook this yet. I'm going to let this continue to marinate in the banana leaves and the tea leaves for about another 45 minutes to an hour. Because actually, I usually like to marinate this in the bag for about an hour to 2 hours, but I didn't have the time to do that tonight. So we're good to go with this. I'm going to take this and set it aside, and Tommy's going to take over and make us a delicious Hawaiian-style piña colada. And I'm going to take my Mai Tai with me. Okay, Tommy, come on.
Aloha, everybody. And he really did cut the leaves out in the jungle. Here's the proof. Okay, piña colada. Here we go. Blender. Ice. Pineapple juice. Cream of coconut. And various rums here. So here we go. This is going to make at least, well, depend on the size of your glass, two or three or four piña coladas. That ought to do it. First I'm going to start with Bacardi Clear. Here. Just free pour. These are strong drinks. You can make them weaker if you want, but this is what we do in the islands here. A little bit of a classic dark rum, just a bit, because I'm going to add more to the top. A little bit of coconut rum, not too much because we're adding real coconuts to it. Some pineapple juice. Oh, by the way, we just picked this pineapple in our yard today and sliced it up. We're going to be using that as a garnish. And we also, every time we cut the top off a pineapple, we replant it. We get more. Right here is cream of coconut. About, I would say, 5 tablespoons. Depending on your taste, the sweeter it is, sweet stuff. It's really good. It's like a coconut cream pie. All right, we are ready to blend. Blend it all up because it's nice and frothy. Got our pineapple garnish. Now, if you go out to your favorite restaurant and bar and they're not doing this, you're not getting a real piña colada. Easily and slightly pour the dark Meyer's rum on the top. You can see it going in there real gently so it kind of stays on the top. There you go. That's a real one. I guess we should have a taste test here. Wonderful. Aloha, everybody. Joy? Joy's back. Well, I'm taking it with me.
Okay, thank you, Tommy, for that. That is a piña colada Hawaiian style. Okay, back to the kalua pork. We've got our little homemade emu here that we've got. We're going to toss that in the oven at a 350 degree oven. It's going to cook in there for about 3 hours, and when we come back, we're going to show you the final product of the kalua pork that you can make anywhere, and I'll see you back here in about 3 hours. Thank you for watching, folks.
you believe this? Look what I fucking did.
I set the bag down and it went all over the front of me.
Okay, everybody, welcome back to the Alternative Chefs show on YouTube. We have our Kahlua pig. It is ready to go, and I'm going to open it up and show you what it looks like. Be careful, it's very hot. Again, this has been in the oven for about 3 hours. We wrapped up about 6 pounds of pork butt in some banana leaves and some tea leaves. It is delicious, and I just want to open this up and show you what it looks like. This is fabulous. Delicious. Okay. This should be nice and tender. It is. It's perfect. I just wanted to show you the final product. Aloha. Thank you for joining me on another episode of The Alternative Chef on YouTube. Kahlua pork. It is so easy. You can do this anywhere you live. You just have to have the right greens, and you roll it up, toss it in the oven. It's fantastic. Aloha. Thank you once again for joining me, folks. I will see you on another episode. Cheers.